So there are two significations. Getting my point? One is that you can't control, and one is that you can control. So before you go and suggest a remedy, work on that thing. You get my point? For an example, ascendant is personality, ascendant is fame. If you are not getting famous, what is the problem? Personality. You have to change your personality. And then change the personality, make it better. Work on your personality, getting my point? This needs to be done. What else is indicated by the ascendant? Body part, right? Body part is something that you can really control. Other things you cannot, because you know you cannot change your personality to a great extent. Personality is what you're born with. My dog cannot eat grass for a lifetime. For some days they can do. Generally in Calcutta, I have seen dogs eating grass also, but rare occurrence. Okay. So ascendant indicates the head, right? And if there is a problem related to the ascendant, something needs to be done related to the head, right? Ascendant is the head, Aries is the head, right? Mm-hmm. So if there's a problem related to ascendant, you have to do something related to the head. And this is a big, big thing for a seminar also, rather you say. And I can earn a huge amount of money if I just start teaching remedies of the ascendant. Webinar 1, remedies of the second house. Webinar 2, remedies of the third house. Webinar 3, remedies of the fourth house. Webinar 4. So, ascendant indicates head, right? Suppose there is sun in the ascendant that is not getting activated. What should you recommend? Sun in the ascendant not getting activated. What do you indicate? Oh, let me tell you one thing. I went bald, not actually bald, but I just cut my hair a lot. Like to a great extent, being inspired by some a designer who was bald. He was having hair fall and I did a mistake. Which planet indicate someone being bald? Sun in the ascendant. My sun is the seventh lord. So I started having problems related to the seventh house. Do you get my point? Ascendant also indicates forehead, right? And what you can do with your forehead? You can put a tikka out there, right? Tikka, what it is called in English. Tilak, you understand, right? We have something on our head like this, covering your head with some stuff that is what we call as this stuff, right? Tikka thing. According to different planets, you can do that. Like hairstyle of every planet, you may not know. And let me tell you, sun is bald. Moon is okay, normal hair, right? Mars is army man. So the side hairs are small and the upper hairs are big. Mercury is a child. So he will never he will never put comb on his hair. It will always be always done by hands only, no comb. Okay. Jupiter is generally having a long hair that he will tie behind because he's a guru or a sage. Venus is having curly hairs and Saturn is having normal hair, but great amount of hair, right? Rahu gets his hair colored and Ketu is, people who will not have hair in this particular area and will only have hair in this particular area of kind of a stuff, right? Like half bald kind of all that. So based on the planet which you want in the ascendant, you can have that type of hairstyle. You want Venus in the ascendant, go get it curly. That may be a bit costly as well. So other thing, right? Something to have on your head, right? Like in Hinduism, we put few things between our eyebrows that is generally called a tika. Mm-hmm. So what does sun indicate? Sun indicate red sandalwood. Mm-hmm. Lal chandan is indicated by sun. Red sandalwood is indicated by sun, right? So red sandalwood paste between your eyebrows for sun. Moon is generally indicative of sandalwood, because that is, you know, that is like a cold in, or like that you say that is cold in nature. Uh-huh. And Mars is about what? Mars is about red sandalwood, right? Mercury is about leaves. So what leaf you can have on your head? Like, you know, many people have belpatra on their head, right? They will generally dip the belpatra into water and have it on their head, right? Jupiter generally indicate any kind of tika. Specifically, the turmeric is haldi, right? Especially the turmeric tika. Venus indicates a curd tika, right? Curd tika is very essential in Devi worship, right? So like you take curd, put dip a finger into it and put it on your head. And Saturn indicate a tika of ashes. Ashes, right? Ashes, you understand? Ashes, like that is given in Mahakaleshwara after some Havana or something, right? So it can get activated this particular way. Mm-hmm. So like this, there are coexisting significations for every house. Now, what I am doing is, this is 10:48. Super. So there is a question by Krishna: to improve the lagna or any other house, you activate the planet in that house. What if the planet is not good for that house? Or is there a thing? Like, yeah, that is a particular thing. So, Krishna, what if we generally do, or what we are doing here is, we want to activate only the good factor. So generally, when the planet is not good into that house or the Rashi, we check where is the problem, whether it is the problem in the house or it is the problem in the Rashi. And we only activate that particular thing. For an example, if there is a Saturn in the ascendant, that Saturn in the ascendant is not very good. Otherwise exalted or Mulatrikona or an own sign. So like, you know, that Saturn will not be good, that Saturn will be bad. In that scenario, we are not supposed to activate Saturn. We are supposed to activate the Lagna Lord. So, you know, we should have the hairstyle like the Lagna Lord, or, you know, the tika should be of the Lagna Lord rather than of the Saturn. So we only want to activate that particular good planet. So I will not be taking every house. I take the major houses only, right? Because all the 12 houses is very difficult to cover in this half an hour, right? Got to my point? Coming to the matter. Like, I am going to put this particular part on YouTube, and if there is much demand, I will do a webinar. Otherwise, second house is also important for the finances, right? And generally, second house indicates the face, right? So the face have to be made according to that planet. And see, the word that is originally used for the second house is Anand. Or, you know, how do you look, or how do you come as? Getting my point? So the outlook, like that planet, or, you know, the planet in the second house generally indicates what is your outlook, or how do you look, or technically how do people perceive you? So that's not from the Arul Lagna, that is from the second house, right? How people perceive you. Like, for an example, I have a Ketu in the second house. So people generally perceive me like Ketu. Or if there's any behavior, I'm like Ketu, right? So the planet in the second house does indicate how you actually is, how you are actually perceived by the society. So when the sun is in the, for sun in the second house, you have to come like someone who is very royal in appearance, right? Royal, having strong likes and dislikes kind of a stuff. For moon, you have to be like, you know, like moon is very light-hearted, kind-hearted kind of a person. And so for Moon, you have to come in that particular way. For Mars, Mars is an, you know, like Mars is an commander in chief. Mars is someone who is guiding people, ruling people, ordering people, commanding people. That is for Mars, right? Mercury comes like a student. Jupiter comes like a teacher. Venus comes like someone, you know, who is very romantic and very much intent on being beautiful, handsome, and good looking. Right? Saturn comes out like someone who is very hardworking. Mm-hmm. So that is what comes to the second house. Coming to the matter of third house. So, you know, I have a statement that second house indicates gemstone. And if there is a malefic in the second house, gemstone should not be worn. Is my technique. And believe me, I'm the first guy who started talking about this. In the free videos and, you know, also sometimes in classes, I do a free talk also, right? You know, off recording. I'm the first one to talk about this particular thing. But then, you know, people from different institutes flocked, watched the videos, and now they have a complete series on how to wear gemstones where they will talk about second house indicates gemstones. So if there's a malefic in the second house, don't wear gemstones. That happens. That happens in the astrological community. But that's, I'm the first guy to talk about this, right? You know, like I am talking about this from that time when this people was not even born in the astrological society. Leaving it aside, what is the third house? Third house indicates hands, right? And in olden times, like, have you seen an olden king? Just a second. So I'm not getting an appropriate image, but I will talk about it. So if you have seen an image of any Indian deity, you will find that they wear something right here in the hand. They wear something like this, right? Generally amulet. Generally it is an amulet, right? So planet in the third house. The things related to that planet should be worn in this area, right? Between the shoulder and the elbow. Things have to be worn in that particular area. And what you can do, you can either take the metal of the planet, or you can take the herb of that planet, or you can take the yantra of that planet. So generally what it is done, a yantra is made on a paper, right? Or gorochan, like the yantra is made upon paper or gorochan, and then it is folded and put into a small locket, and that locket is worn on this particular area of hand. Getting my point? So this is what is done for the planet. If you don't have gorochan, etc., you can also make the yantra on a white paper. There are generally two type of planetary yantras. I will tell you the simpler one. One is this type of yantra. This you see? This type of yantra. It is difficult to make. Don't you think so? We have a simpler version. This yantra, or rather take this English one, this yantra. So what you have to do, leave the previous image, just make a box with 9 parts into it and just write these numbers. This will make a yantra for the particular planet. And just take the color of the planet, right? So for Sun, you take the orange color. Right? For Mercury, you take a green pen and make these 9 boxes and write these numbers. You have a yantra ready, simplified. Right? And this yantra of letters come from the concept of Panchadashi yantra or Bisa yantra, which is generally numbers written. And these yantras of planets come from the planetary yantras. Right? So any of them you can take. This is very much powerful. And this is also powerful, right? It is not like that this is not that powerful. This is also very powerful. Like, you know, like Sun Yantra is this. So 6, 1, 8, 3, 5, 7, 2, 9, 4. Got my point? This is what you can do. Numbers you can easily write. Easy. And, you know, Yantra is for protection. Always. Because third house is tension. Yantra is protection. And third lord's yantra, you should always be doing. Third, the lord signified by signified by the third lord or the planet in the third house does indicate the god who's going to protect you. Got it? Now coming to the fourth house. For second house, other than appearance, second house also indicates neck and throat. You can also wear something for the planet in the second house. Right? Generally, the Rudraksha of the planet. But Rudraksha have a whole lot of rules and regulations, right? So I will only recommend the metal of the planet. Okay? Like copper, silver, a mix of five metals, etc. is what you can wear. Right? In the neck for the planet. But there is a difference between the locket that you wear for the planet of the second house and the planet of the fourth house. To remedy the planet in the second house, you generally wear something that is very tight on the neck that only comes to this level. Be very tight to the neck. For the planet in the fourth house, you wear a long necklace that comes down to the center of the heart. A big necklace kind of a stuff and a small thread-like structure, right? So this is the difference between the second house and the fourth house. And should I give you a technique? Matchmaking technique. So in India, there is a concept of Mangal Sutra, right? And generally, Mangal Sutras are all, you know, like up to the chest, generally. It is a long structure. It is not a small structure. So you know what? If there is a planet in the fourth house, then that particular planet should have a connection with the ascendant or the seventh house of the spouse. Otherwise, it is a total mismatch and the marriage will be a disaster because heart is not matching. What do you want to find in the spouse is not matching? Don't you think it is problematic? It is. Understood. Now, coming to the fifth house. What does fifth house indicate? What do you think fifth house will indicate? Can you have something in your stomach? Or can you wear something on your stomach? Yes, I generally cannot. So what comes from the fifth house? Let me tell you. Third house is from the shoulder to the elbow. Fourth house is the elbow. And fifth house is from the elbow to the hands. So the bracelet that you just wear here, like you know this Maniband area, the bracelet that you wear at this particular place comes in the fifth house. Right? So the hand opens in this way, right? From the third house to the fifth house is where hands will open. So generally people having good planets in the fifth house, they have very good signs on their hands, right? You know, people having good planets in the fifth house will have a very good hand lines. Like anyone having benefic influencing the fifth house or fifth lord being under benefic influence, you know, their hand lines will be very good. You know, like well-shaped nails, etc. Got my point? Now, what about the sixth house? What you can do for sixth house indicates back. And you know, there is something Okay. So if you can see, this is what generally what Kardhani is called in English, Abhilasha. I am like very hard to find the word. You see this particular thing that is war on the naval area. It is generally done in the bridal things, right? You know, like you can see this lady wearing it. It's generally worn on this particular area. So this is all the sixth house indicates the lower abdomen. So this is generally worn by ladies. And you know what? There is a tradition in Bihar. When someone will have a short life, when a child will have a short life, it is indicated that the Shashti Devi is the goddess who comes on cat and they eat the children of those people who are not religious enough. So to pacify that particular deity, what they, because see, males cannot wear this particular thing, right? So what they do, they will take some sesame seed. Sesame is sarson, right? Right, Abhilasha ji? What is sarson? Sesame?
No, mustard, mustard.
Okay. So they will take they will take some sarson sesame. What English I have?
Nay, sesame is teal.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, mustard. So they will take a few mustard seeds, and you know this is a tradition. And my father is very well into this. So you know if there is any problem, what he will do, he will take some mustard seeds and he will do a mantra and blow, like he will have that mustard seed into his hand. He will do the mantra 108 times and will blow 108 times. He will do the mantra. Then he will take some mustard seeds. Then he will do that mantra 3 times and he will do it 1 time. He will, like, you know, blow into it. He will do it 3 times and he will give that thing to the person. And it is used in a multitude of things, right? So for finances, he will give you that mustard seed and you have to keep it at the place where you keep money, right? If the animal is having a disease, you have to like spread that mustard seed into the place where the animal is living. If someone is having health problem, then you have to put that mustard seed behind their pillow, right? So generally what is done is we take the planet who is bad. See, what is mantra? And I think for planets for planets there are two three type of mantras, or for any planet there are two three type of mantras, right? One who talks about the planet or the deity. A mantra that is just to eulogize the deity or talk about the deity. Getting my point? Like there is a mantra for Lakshmi, so Lakshmi Padmasana Stita Devi. And so Lakshmi is a goddess sitting in the Padmasana posture. It is just talking about Lakshmi. Getting my point? Then there will be a so for planet, there is, you know, like Japa Kusum Sankasam Kasatayam Mahadutin, that shloka. That mantra just talks about that sun is of this nature, this color, etc., etc. So that mantra you use when the planet is connected to the ascendant. Getting my point? Because it is talking about the nature of the planet and you want to have that nature, right? Then there are mantras like Om Pram Prim Prom Shaniye Namah, that tantric mantras. These mantras are done just to activate the planet. Or normal mantras are done just to get into the notice of the planet. Getting my point? Like Om Vishnave Namah is just to get the notice of Vishnu. Then there are protection mantras to get protected from that particular thing, right? So like when like it is generally for deities, there this is Kavach, right? And for planets, you know, there is Pida Hari Stotra, right? So there is the Navagraha Pida Hari Stotram. That is in Brahmand Puran, right? And these shlokas are like this, and yeah, there is an English transliteration also. So you know, this is the shloka for Sun, Grahanama Diraditya, Log Rakshan Karaka, Visamstana Sambhutam, Pidam Hartu Miravi. So this is, you know, these are the shloka for every planet. So planet in the sixth house, what he's going to do, he's going to wound you, attack you. Take this protection mantra. And there is a count for, you know, the planet. Like, you know, 21,000 for Sun. There's a count like that, right? So starting from a good day, from a good muhurta, right? You know, Surya Saptami or some Amavasya or some Grahan, etc. You start. And you take a pledge that I will complete the 21,000 counting in, say, 21 days or 21 weeks, whatever you take. Mm-hmm. And then you complete the count. After that particular count, you have to do a small fire ritual, a small sacrifice, fire sacrifice. And like generally people of other religion are not able to do that fire sacrifice. So donation. Like if I have done 21,000 mantra, then then 21 kgs of something I have to donate. 21 kgs of food or something I have to donate once I am done with this. Okay. And after that, I will do the mantra of the planet 108 times. And we'll blow it into the, what was the name? Mustard seed. Or like you can take 108 mustard seeds, right? So you take one mustard seed once, put it into your hand, do the mantra, keep it at the separate place, right? So 108 mustard seed, you will do the mantra 108 times and you keep on putting it at different place, right? After that, take the 108 of them together and bind it with the colored cloth, right? Like for Jupiter, take a yellow cloth, for Saturn, take a black cloth kind of, right? And then stitch it to a thread that you can tie around your around your waist. Then, so that is for male as well as for female, because generally this ornament that we have just saw in the starting cannot be worn every time. Getting my point? Like if you are going to sleep, you cannot wear it. That is highly discomforting. So this thing should be done, and specifically when there is a health problem, when there is a disease based problem. It works like magic. You try it. Like doing this is a bit difficult, but then getting out of the disease is also difficult. Difficult things needs difficult remedy. Easy thing, easy remedy, simple as that, right? We understand, right? What about the seventh house? I don't know what it is called in India, what it is called in South India. Yep. So this is, I have used the word that we used in Bihar. Okay. So generally in Bihar, women wear something like this in their legs. And this is prevalent in, I think, every culture. There is some, like touring is what you can say, touring technically, right? So 7th house is the feet of Vishnu, if he's standing. And 12th house is the feet of Vishnu if he's sleeping. And you don't want Vishnu to sleep, because then who will come to rescue? So you want him to stand, right? Planet in the 7th house, this particular thing, like the touring of the metal of that planet can be worn, right? Generally, the fiery metals like gold, copper, etc. are not worn in the leg. So just the silver is worn in the leg, generally. Silver touring is the only option that you have. In that case, I just taught you how to infuse something with mantra, right? So once again, you can take the Namaskar mantra of the planet. Now understand it. First we did the mantra that was more focused on that this planet should protect me. Now you should take a mantra that is more focused on I pay obeisance to this planet. Or I pay my devotion to this planet. Got it? So that type of mantra should be taken. And infusing this with that type of mantra, you should wear it in your toe ring, right? In your toe. Understood? Uh-huh. Now what about the 8th house? What you can do for the planet in the 8th house?
Donate or throw away.
Eighth house is very much related to the devotional worship is what I will rather say. Because the planet of the eighth house is highly, you know, like highly disastrous, devastating. Getting my point. So that is very much related to worshipping the planet with all, you know, complete rituals. Getting it done through the rituals, and you don't do it. You get someone else to do it. Getting my point? You get someone else to do it. A proper ritualistic worship for the planet in the 8th house is recommended. Just don't play with the energies of the 8th house. There is a saying in our, I will tell you a joke. So there was a mushaira going on, okay? Mushaira is like a Urdu poetry session. And a person was singing the sher, singing the couplet. And other person was saying, Allah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah, right? This is like, oh great, like, you know, Subhanallah, Subhanallah is what he was doing, like taking the name of Allah. So, you know, poet sitting beside the person told ki, dekhiye, I will translate it in English. Dekhiye, Allah ka naam zor se mat lijiye, kyunki aap bula rahe hain to theek hai. Usne bula liya to bahut gadbad hoga. So he just told ki, don't take the name of God so loudly. You are calling him, that is okay, but if he calls you, that will be a trouble. Right? So that is what goes with the plan of the 8th house. You call him, that is okay. If he calls you, that will be very bad, right? So you take other person to call him, you don't. Right? That is something important. And generally the pandit or the person who is going to do the puja should make sure that, like, you know, if I am having Rahu in the 8th house, I should not get the Rahu mantra done by another pandit who is having Rahu in the 8th house. Because usko bula liya to. So be careful about it. Just because, you know, you will not want that the person who is performing remedy for you suffers because of it. Right? So, like, you know, ignorance may lead to problems. Right. 9th house is a temple. Right? So going to the temple, visiting the temple of that particular deity is very powerful for the 9th house. And 10th house is your throne. So take the metal of the planet and the 10th house and have your chair related to the planet of the 10th house, right? Like I have Mars as my 10th lord. So I always sit on a highly mechanical chair where every part is removable. And you know, like every part is like in this chair of mine, some 8-9 parts are moving. And so I can change it according to my wish and desire, etc. Right? So when there is a sun, you should prefer having a wooden chair. Hitting the word like that. Or rather say workplace is what is indicated by the 10,000. Like, so if there is a moon in the 10,000, you cannot have a silver chair, that will be very costly. Right. Neither you can have a chair made up of water, or you cannot sit on a wet place. So what you can rather do is, you know, like on your table, you can have some water related thing, right? You know, some water body or a water, this small fountain kind of something. This is what you can have, right? And 10th house is also very much related to the things that are in the back side, you know, the back wall, Because, you know, when you are approaching people, when you are approaching public, they are in the 4th house. And you are in power and you are in the 10th house, right? So the image behind you should resemble the planet of the 10th house. Getting my point?
इसमें भी अगर सर
आई शुड नॉट नो द सीक्रेट एंड यू नो ऑलवेज लाइक आई विल ऑलवेज रिकमेंड हैविंग द इमेज ऑफ अ गॉड बिहाइंड यू यू नो व्हाई अ नॉर्मल राशि बेस्ड इमेज और सम अदर इमेज मे गिव यू इजी फेम और गुड प्रोमिनेंस राइट बट बीइंग गाइडेड बाय द गॉड इज ऑलवेज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज यू नो यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू रूइन यूर कर्मा एट द एंड ऑफ द डे. We know of many successful astrologers who lost their lives in accident, who lost their lives because of cancer, who have lost everything in their lives, right? Because they are not being guided by a good principle. Getting my point? So you have to get guided by a good principle. Understood? But to earn money, you should not start, you know, like you should not start fixing people who will always give a good review for you. Getting my point? Otherwise, you are not improving in the profession. If you are doing it just for the sake of that, I should earn some money and start some farming business later on, then it is okay. Fine. What about the 11th house? There is no need of special webinar. I have covered all the houses, but planets remaining, mantras remaining, that you will find yourself. I am very, very sure. What about the 11th house? Month one, you can do it. Because see, now in the 9th house is thighs. You cannot wear something on your thighs. You cannot wear something on whole of your body. Come on, so much of expense. Robbing, you will be like robbing a bank. Don't become laden with gold. You cannot go outside. People will be like, isko pakdo. He's a bank, moving bank, so many ornaments. You don't do that. Like someone specifically asked this particular thing, that why do I wear this on my hand, right? This is a silver thing. This is made up of silver specifically because that's because Jupiter is respecting my 5th house. I want this Jupiter to be here always. That's why. And it is changed every year on a particular day. So that I'm not going to expose, of course. But yeah, still. So that is because of you want Jupiter in your 5th house? A silver bracelet. That is whatever you say.
सर इस टेक्निक में मतलब अगर पहले से आपका कोई प्लेनेट एस्पेक्ट कर रहा है तो ही हो सकता है या फिर वो कहीं पे भी हो फिर भी हो सकता है.
देखो इफ द प्लेनेट इज ऑलरेडी हैविंग अ कनेक्शन इट इज इजी टू एक्टिवेट. इफ द प्लेनेट इज नॉट हैविंग अ कनेक्शन इट विल हैव मल्टीपल एफर्ट्स टू एक्टिवेट. गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? इफ द कनेक्शन इज ऑलरेडी देयर इट इज इजी. If it is not there, then it will not be easy. It will be a bit difficult. You have to do more and more, a bit more, right? Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So what about the 11th house? Now you people got stuck. Eh? What about the 11th house? See, 11th house is income, right? And I have specifically found this, I was about to talk about this in a video, and I think I will do in a free video, I will talk about it extensively. But what is the biggest problem in accumulation of money? You don't have a particular place to keep money, generally. We put money in bank accounts, etc., right? We don't have a particular amount of money at our home, or there is no fixed place to have it. There will be money in your pocket and then you will you will open your pant and the money will remain in the pocket, right? Or you will throw it somewhere on the table or somewhere near your bed. Wrong practice. Very wrong practice. So I always ask one question, okay, that money was into your pocket and you removed your trouser and it went all through your legs and everything. So is there any respect left for that particular thing? Getting my mind. So first thing that you need to do to have a good finances in life, to have a particular place for money. Let it sit at a particular place, right? And generally, you don't keep it on a bare stuff. You don't keep it on a bare metal or something, because we considered money as something that is very holy, Lakshmi. See, try understanding something. A person who doesn't respect money can also have money. Money comes through Kubera and money comes through Lakshmi. When it comes through Lakshmi, it gives you happiness as well. When it comes through Kubera, it doesn't give you happiness, right? So, see, being wealthy is something else. Being contented and happy is something else. You can have a whole lot of money, still remain dissatisfied. You can have very few amount of money, still remain satisfied. So that satisfaction is the tussle between Kubera and Lakshmi. So for the 11th house, choose the direction where you are going to keep money according to the 11th house. And also choose the color of cloth that you are going to put below they put over the place depending on the planet in the 11th house. And one more stuff, you know what? 11th house is 10th house from the second house. And those people, those cute people who took admission in my Skandhora course and stole the technique and now teaching it in their own webinars, let me tell you that particular thing, my friend. That you may have stolen the technique from my course that second house indicates gemstone, and if there is a malefic in the second house, the gemstone should not be worn. But let me tell you one more particular thing. You know, it is told that Munga, coral, is very favorite to Lakshmi. And if you want to get Lakshmi, depending on if the Venus is in the sign of Sun, Moon, Jupiter, you should use the Spatik Mala. If the Venus is in the sign of Venus or Mercury, you should have Kamal Gatte Ka Mala, that is the seed of the lotus flower. And if the Venus is in the sign of Saturn or Mars, then you should use the Coral Mala, the rosary of coral. Because Lakshmi loves Spatik, Kamal Gatta and coral equally. You know what is the hint? If you cannot wear a gemstone, you can worship the gemstone. Always. I want to strengthen my moon, but my moon is the sixth lord. What I should do? I should rather worship pearl, or should take a pearl and keep it at the place where I keep the money. Because what is more valuable than a gemstone? Getting my point. I want God to give me gemstones. That is even more powerful than money. Isn't it? So the gemstone of the planet related to the 11th house, not to wear it, just to have that in your locker, that particular gemstone. Getting my point? It is a very strong remedy. Rather than, see, I'm an astrologer, right? 11 years. Any gemstone that you can see, no body part. Experimenting with bodies, I don't like. Getting my point? Experiment with the drawer. Change the table if it is not suiting. You cannot change your body. Generally. Understood? 12th house is donation or throwing away things, etc. Right? So plant related to the 12th house, you should donate those particular things, etc. Is what you can do. Mm-hmm. So these are the coexisting significations of different houses. When you have a planet in the house and the planet is not able to activate, and the planet is not able to activate, you do this to activate the planet. Or if you want to get the result of a desired planet in that house, you can also use this remedy. Right? Uh-huh. Enjoyed the class, I am very sure. Let's continue in the next class, next Friday. Thank you.